welcome to the 2016 Parsippany High School Winter Concert. Our first selection is "And Sweet Singing in the Choir," composed by Douglas E. Wagner. From the very beginning, the piece contains a continual rhythmic pattern of eight notes at a persistent tempo that instantly creates a happy and joyful tone. The piece's layered harmonies and fluctuating dynamics make for a holiday song that truly conveys the excitement and enthusiasm of the holiday season. We hope you enjoy "And Sweet Singing in the Choir."
Thank you. Thank you. see much.
The Women's Ensemble will be performing a piece entitled In Winter by Victor C. Johnson. If you listen closely, you will hear pieces of Still, 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 a traditional German carol. Overall, this piece brings out beautiful melodies and harmonies and rises and falls in dynamics to bring you to a beautiful time.
Thank you.
special Southern Winters, which will be sung by an immense choir, is written by John Parker and Vicki Tucker Courtney, and is about the short winters of the South. This piece is very different from some of our other selections in terms of style and rhythm, and I hope you enjoy the immense choir rendition of One of Those Southern Winters.
Thank you. songs traditionally sung during Hanukkah. The first song is entitled O Hanukkah. It's an English version of the Yiddish Oy Chanukah. The second, My Otzer, is usually sung after the lighting of festival lights. We hope you enjoy this Hanukkah fantasy.
Thank you. choir is filing back on. We've been off to a really good start this year, and I wanted to acknowledge some students that were accepted into our Marist Area Honor Choir this fall, which was hosted here at Parsippany High School, which is really exciting for us. We had 7 students accepted, and they performed in October, and I wanted to acknowledge those students at this time. So for soprano 1, we had Amanda Chen. Soprano 2, Juliana Smith. Alto 1, Catherine Chirlanza. Alto 1, Kathy Hogan. Alto 1, Stephanie Hernandez. Alto 2, Richa Iyer. And Alto 2, Karen Sheet. We also have 4 students perform in Atlantic City at the New Jersey All-State Mixed Choir concert. They also performed at the New Jersey TAC on November 20th, and they got the opportunity to work with Rollo Dilworth, who is a very well-known composer of choral music, and it was a great experience for me as well. Just watching him was amazing. And those students are Anya, Anya, soprano 1. Veronica Mendoza, alto 2. Josh Gonzalez, tenor 2. And Bobby Wilson, bass 1. I'm so proud of all of them. We have 14 students auditioning for regions in January, which is a high for us, so we're very excited. So thank you for your support, as always.
Our next selection, Sing We With Gladness, is one of the most challenging pieces we have worked on for this concert. This 5-part arrangement by Audrey Snyder is unique because of its harmonic lines and the polyphony between all 5 vocal lines. It is based on the song Wanton by Anthony Holborn, who was alive during the Renaissance period. We hope that this song of spirit will help us all to, as quoted in the text, banish all sadness and to celebrate this festive time of year.
Opportunity to sit and watch, which I'm really excited about. We have this year a Target Teach apprentice for choir, That is a program that we have at Park City High School where seniors have the opportunity to do almost like a mini student teaching with a teacher in the field that they want to pursue. This year, Josh Gonzalez is working with me for choir, and so far has done an amazing job, just taking off with everything that we do and learning more and working hard. And he's going to conduct, he's worked with the classes, and he's going to conduct this next piece. So I'm very excited. I get to sit and watch, and Josh gets to conduct, and he's done an amazing job. So I just wanted to mention that before they start.
Thank you.
is a choral tune written by Gustav Holst, who is also a composer who's written a lot of great stuff for the wind band literature. This piece was written in 1908, and this setting of the piece was arranged by a band composer, Robert W. Smith, who some of you may have played pieces for, or pieces by in the past. One of the unique things about this arrangement of the piece is that it's dedicated to this woman, Alta Sue Hawkins, who's actually a retired Virginia music teacher, or was, and Robert W. Smith took this piece and dedicated it to her. In remembrance of her, he rescored this in a very unique way. I like to share the story when we do this piece. After we have this nice opening fanfare that you'll hear, the first part of the theme is stated in the clarinet. So you'll hear that played over here by Will in the clarinet section. That represents the teacher, Miss Hawkins. She was a clarinet player, and she taught for more than 3 decades. The clarinet is then joined by the French horn, okay, and alto sax. We have them playing. And then also the euphonium joins in, and then a second horn joins in as well. And that represents Miss Hawkins and each of her children, each of her 3 children, on their specific instruments that they play. The composer here, he also uses the American folk melody Shenandoah, which if you ever did Regent Choir or Morris Airy, you probably used that piece or had to sing it for auditions. I know I did when I was in high school. And you'll hear that theme played in the horn and the euphonium later on, and that represents Ms. Hawkins' home state of Virginia. Kind of cool, right? The beautiful valley, the Shenandoah Valley of Virginia. Ironically enough, in December of 92, Robert B. Smith actually married into the Hawkins family, and this setting was a tribute to her, you know, dedicated to his wife and, you know, and her brothers, and a dedication and tribute to the mom, Alta Sue. So, a little unique story, story of family for the holidays, you know, it's nice. So we hope you enjoy this really, really neat arrangement of In the Bleak Midwinter.
Thank you.
Exhale, performed by Enya and arranged by Audrey Snyder, is an elegant composition that leaves you remembering the peaceful memories of silent winter nights. Through its beautiful harmonies, gentle pulsing chords, and expressions, reflective text, this piece never fails to give you warm feelings these first seasons. We will be performing this piece with the CMS 8th grade chorus. As I finish here, I must tell you to enjoy and remember the blue moon light.
Remember the blue moonlight upon the bonfire. Remember sleepless
All right, so we have a little bit of a staging change. This next tune is a really neat piece to kind of close out the wind ensemble portion of the program. The whole piece was kind of arranged or created by using various carols, some standard carols that you used to hear around this time of year, some non-traditional. But the opening fanfare is actually brought to you by antiphonal trumpets. So we have Adam over here, we have Mickey over there, and then eventually you're going to see antiphonal trombones. I know, brace yourselves. We have Stephen over there, and Anthony over there, alright? So, what antiphonal means, nowadays, they say Dolby, digital surround sound. It's kind of like that, where we have the sound coming from both sides of the stage. It'll give a different effect as if they were standing, or sitting in the back together as a section. So you'll hear this fanfare started by the trumpets, and then throughout you're going to hear a bunch of various carols that you're like, oh, I know that. I've heard that one before, because you probably have. So see how many you can hear. You're going to hear a little maybe Angels We Have Heard on High, a little Away in the Manger, a little Carol of the Bells. So give a listen and see how many you can pick out. Finale for Winter Festival by James Curnow to close out our wind ensemble set. Thank you. will now hand things back over to the choir. While they're getting set up, just really quickly, I want to bring to your attention a bunch of the students that are up on here. We'll do this as the choir's getting set real quick. We recently had our area band auditions, so I just want to let you guys know who made it in this year. So in our wind ensemble, we have Ethan Kaplan, making the symphonic band, we had Cynthia Brown on oboe. We have Victoria Dobkowski on clarinet. Nick Colella, alto sax. Nikki Hansen on trumpet. Adam Yee also on trumpet. Steve Gerson on the trombone. And Eric Lai on the mallet. We had an all-national band student. Ethan Kaplan traveled all the way to Grapevine, Texas. And down here in the choir, actually, Amanda Chen actually made it to All-State Orchestra this year. So good for Amanda Chen.
I'll Be Home for Christmas, arranged by Greg Gilpin, with words and music by Kim Gannon and Walter Kent, will be performed by the PHS Chamber Choir. The song was first released in 1943 and is written in the perspective of a soldier serving overseas in World War II. The story itself is about longing, because the title I'll Be Home for Christmas indicates that being home for Christmas is not yet a reality. Our performance of this piece includes beautiful harmonies as well as a major seventh as our ending chord. The song will feature singers from our choir who took part in the 2016 NJ All-State Choir, which are myself, Ron Mendoza, Anya Kosachevich, Bobby Wilson, and Josh Gonzalez. We hope you enjoy our rendition of this lovable Christmas classic.
Thank you.
thank our accompanist, Mrs. Kristen, I'm sorry, I'm having trouble talking tonight, Kristen Cappuccino, who is always the amazing. Set up for our final two selections. We were going to have combined bands and choir, so we just need a minute for that. Thank you.
Go in the back.
Holiday favorites arranged by Roger Emerson and Paul Lavender will be performed by our combined band and concert choir. It includes some of America's most beloved winter songs and holiday hits, such as Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, King of the Rocks, Silver Bells, and Frosty the Snowman. We hope you enjoy this in-tune medley, and certainly feel free to sing along.
Thank you.
Before we sing our final selection, there are so many people that we need to thank to make this all possible. I apologize if I forget anybody, but here we go. First and foremost, our administration at Parsippany High School, they're the best.
Yeah.
They are so supportive, and thank you for everything. Our Board of Education, thank you as well for your support of our program. Thank you. Mr. Gilger, our sound and lighting and stagecraft group. Ms. Ame Doyle in the PHS Interact Club, thank you. We thank Video on the Go for being here this evening and recording our concert, thank you. Our custodial and secretarial staff are all they do for us. They're always helping us, and we thank you for everything. Thank you. Thank you, too, for what you've done for us for our concert. Thank you. Of course, our band boosters and our chorus booster club, you work so hard for us, and you make, you make this possible, and we thank you for everything. Thank you so much. For all of our parents, relatives, friends that came out this evening, thank you so much for your support. We have such a wonderful group of young men and women to work with, and they love what they do, and we know that that love comes from what you instill in them. Thank you so much. Our 8th grade chorus and our 8th grade band, thank you for joining us this evening. Mrs. Cappuccino and Mr. Iguano, thank you for working with us. And last but certainly not least, we thank you, the students that we work with every day. I know for me, I love every day coming to work and 7:40 in the morning singing together. We have such a great time, and they want to learn so much, and they've grown so much, and I look so forward to March and May and all the things we're going to do in the future. I am so proud of all of you. Band, choir, thank you for working so hard.
Just a quick thing to add on, a couple of things from before. Our 50-50 winners, the Carrillo family, they donated it back to the Mendoza family, so thank you for that. Choir boosters will continue to accept donations, so you can contact us if you want to get through to them, or you can email them directly. The information is on phsbands.com if you want to get to the band boosters, and they will be able to get to the choir boosters. The donations, and there's also a GoFundMe page to help them as well. So thank you once again for being very kind and warm during this time of year, and you know, continue to have a great rest of 2016, and we hope everyone, you know, as a wonderful rest of your night. I'm going to stop talking again.
The Hallelujah Chorus is part of the oratorio Messiah by Handel, concluding the second of three parts. It is Handel's best known piece and remains hugely popular. In many parts of the world, it is traditional for the audience to stand during the Hallelujah Chorus. Legend has it that King George II was so moved by the music that he stood to his feet when he heard it, requiring that his subjects follow suit. We hope you enjoy.
And of course, at this time, we'd like to invite all alumnus who would like to sing with us to please come forward. I can't see, so I don't know where you are, so come on up.
While our alum are joining joining us, we wanted to just remind everyone, this is, we're celebrating the 60th anniversary of Parsippany High School this year, 60 years. How many alums do we have in the audience? Just raise your hand or cheer. All right, awesome. So throughout the year, keep an eye on the PHS website for other 60th anniversary events that'll be happening. Thank you.